Well, it would certainly be the envy of much of the developed world, the simple fact that Australia has enjoyed a record 21 years without a recession. But a report out today warns that the mining boom may soon be at an end. And while that has an impact, obviously, economically, it also has a political edge, as Eddy Meyer reports.
It's been seen as the saviour of the Australian economy, the word mining always matched with the word boom. But today, a reality check. In a report, Deloitte Access Economics does say that the Australian economy remains a global standout compared with its developed nation peers, but that is where the good news ends. The mining boom will peak, it says, in the next couple of years. That will affect economic growth and lift unemployment. The price of imports will almost certainly rise, and our dollar could slide back to 80 US cents. Bottom line, if the budget were brought down today, it would be in deficit. Believe the Treasurer on budget night in May, and he saw it coming.
The forecasts are that the terms of trade will come off 5.75%.
We have factored the decline in mineral prices into the budget.
But this new report warns the slowdown is coming more steeply and more quickly than predicted.
Other economists, HSBC for one, predict that iron ore, our major export, will be in oversupply in 2014, and that has to have an impact on prices. But not everyone's convinced by the gloomy prognosis, and they're the ones the Prime Minister would prefer to believe.
This report is actually called The Glass is Half Full, so it is reinforcing the strength of the Australian economy.
Are you worried about the budget not returning to surplus?
The budget will return to surplus.
For the opposition, an easy hit on the mining tax.
The government needs to explain what taxes it's going to increase to make up for the budget shortfall.
The mining industry, of course, says there's nothing to worry about. It's optimistic jobs growth will be steady until the end of the decade.
You'll actually see a change in job mix from construction to production and process. We see this as the normal flow and ebb and flow of the resource sector.
Some things in mining have begun to fall already. BHP, Rio Tinto and Fortescue have all seen their share prices fall by 20% or more since the start of the year.
Now, earlier I spoke to Morgan Stanley's chief economist, Gerard Minack, about that report. Now, he's been monitoring the Australian economy from a global perspective and has been one of the few prepared to speculate on the possible downside. Gerard, you've been predicting the collapse of the mining boom for a number of years now. All of a sudden, you're finding a lot more economists in your corner.
As a country, we've had a great decade, in fact, a great two decades, and particularly over the last 10 years, the rest of the world gave us a pay rise every year. They paid us more for our iron ore, more for our copper, and what it meant to us as consumers was it simply meant we had to export fewer tonnes of coke and coal to get that imported BMW. So it was making us all better off. The risk now is prices are starting to come off, and I think they're going to continue to decline, not so much because Asia is going to blow up in my view, but supply is increasing. And if supply increases, all else equal, that tends to put pressure down on prices.
Just how realistic do you think these predictions really are?
I just think it's going to end badly. You know, we've had this fantastic free kick from the rest of the world that just made it very easy to manage the economy over the last decade. Really, a drover's dog could have done it. I think we had better than a drover's dog, but it was an easy task.
All right, so just how bad is this fall going to be? What do we need to brace ourselves for?
We will have a recession. Whether it's next year, it's a chance. If it's not next year, there's a good chance it'll be the year after or the year after that. There's a whole generation of people that have never seen a recession. It will be a rude shock to a lot of people. The trouble for Australia now is those two coats of Teflon have faded. The commodity prices are coming off. I think people are less willing to borrow, banks are less willing to lend. And my own view is that means next time we see a global shock, Australia will get bowled over.
But I mean, growth has been strong, inflation's low, unemployment's low, and there are a lot of estimates in this report that I suppose underpin the key findings, and they could yet prove to be a little too conservative.
For sure. I mean, look, every forecast could be wrong. Well, you've got to point out that there's good and bad in all this, just like there was with the mining boom, because for sure we got some benefits, but the industries that are being squeezed by the very high currency will get some relief. Because if commodity prices come off, it's almost certain that the Aussie dollar will come down, manufacturing will do a bit better, tourism will do a bit better.
If indeed the burst of this mining bubble is imminent, when it's all weighed and measured, do you think Australia as a nation will have enough to show for it?
sad to say, I don't think we're going to have much to show for it. What I think would have been a better alternative, this is what other countries have done, is put it into a national piggy bank by taxing the mining wealth more effectively and saving it for a rainy day or saving it for future generations. I think, by and large, this boom will end and we will have very little to show for it.